Hello, my friends. In this time together, we're going to explore three essentials for creators, artists, entrepreneurs who wish to experience the deep and profound satisfaction of going all the way from conception of a novel idea or creation, all the way through the creation, all the way through the release, all the way through receiving back. In whatever way that is for what you've for what you've created. And these three things are simple, straightforward, and grounded. And what I've realized as a creator who doesn't like her freedom stifled, who loves to be improvisational and go with the flow of things, is that I actually need and have had to create for myself some simple, basic structure and inner discipline. Inner discipline. The inner discipline comes from love and commitment to yourself. I've had to develop that inner discipline to bring forth that which wants to come through. Because without that inner discipline, without these three pieces that I'm about to share with you, and I've certainly experienced this and I witness it in many creators that I work with, we can end up unintentionally self-sabotaging. Unintentionally draining our energy and being fatigued because we're not experiencing a kind of powerful streamline from conception to birth to sort of launch or release into the world. So, you ready? Grab a pen and paper. We're going to cover these three things fairly simply. Here we go. Okay, the three things are get clear, be committed, and act. Get clear, be committed, and act. I can promise you that if you allow these principles to work with you in very simple and straightforward ways, and you resist the temptation to overcomplicate things, it will be so deeply satisfying to you. Okay? Number one, get clear. Look, I know that sometimes things can feel confusing, that through fear and worry, we can feel obscured from actually what it is that we're committed to and the uniqueness of what we're bringing forth. But the truth is, when we just focus on what's there, that we came into this life to commit to. Everything gets really simple from there. Okay, so when I say get clear on what you're committed to, this is usually is kind of a broad sense or a broad knowing. So it could be, I'm committed to the cultivation of freedom. I'm committed to awakening and awareness. I'm committed to justice. I'm committed to compassion. I'm committed to, for me, I'll share mine. I am committed to embodied power. I am committed to living in a way and guiding others in a way where we are continually, progressively, directly accessing our God selves, our power as creators and co-creators in this life. I am 100% committed to that. While the things that I do and the offerings that I teach evolve and change over time, at the core, this commitment is there. It was there when I was doing massage therapy. It was there when I was teaching aerobics. It was there when I was waiting tables. It was there when I was an acupuncturist. It's here as a coach to world changers. This is at the core. The second part of step one, you get clear on what you're committed to. Let it be simple. Feel it. You know it right now. What is it? Want to put it in the comments? What is it? Second half of part one. Connect what you're committed to your desires for yourself in this life. If there's a disconnect between what you truly desire in this life for yourself and what you're committed to as a soul, you will unintentionally repeatedly sabotage. So, what is meant by this? If you're clear that you are here as a transmitter and activator of freedom, and you desire in this life to have financial freedom, to travel, to enjoy what you consider luxurious things, if you don't connect those two together, and if somehow in a belief structure you actually feel like they can't connect together, can you see how you will not be able to progress smoothly and receive back from the very thing that you're committed to in this life? Okay, that's number one. Get clear on what you are committed to and spend some time in contemplation, genuine contemplation, not worrying, not overthinking, but how does what you're committed to connect to what you desire? Allow more space and room for you to let those two come together. At any point, if you want support in this, in birthing your brilliance, your creative brilliance, while also going deeper into union with your desire, consider working one-on-one with me. Consider a private retreat with me. You can click on the link for my website there below and explore these options. Number two, be committed. The way that this commitment shows up for real is by you deciding to back up what you're committed to with action. Let's use myself as an example. I'm committed to embodied power, to the awakening of our God selves in this life. If I am backing that up with action, that means that I am endeavoring to live this way in my life. Is it perfect? No. Am I enormously ungraceful sometimes? Yes. But do I keep showing up even when I've been knocked down hard, hard, intense, momentary failures for real? Yes. And do I get up again? Yes. That's the decision. No matter what, this is who I am and this is what I came here to do. Failure is always a stepping stone to the next success. When you decide to back up what you're committed to in this life, it will blow your mind how fast you up level, how swiftly your confidence builds. And conversely, if you don't decide to back it up, you will erode your esteem in yourself. Day after day will pass, and you'll increase the voices of doubt, the voices of discouragement will get louder. We are taught that we can't be the success that we want to be until those feelings go away, until those thought forms of doubt go away. It's not true. The swiftest way that you can build the confidence in yourself, build the esteem, and evict thoughts of doubt is to move into action. And that takes us into step three. So get clear on what you're committed to, step one. Decide to back it up with action, step two. The decision is a real process. Let me put it this way, it's a real step in this process. I've decided this is the way I'm going to live. The decision becomes something real and powerful when we back it up with action. If we don't back it up with action, the decision sort of fizzles and erodes and becomes squashy, and we don't get to receive from that decision. So, step three is act. Let me write here. The most simple way that you can act on your decision is to set aside time every day or a certain number of days per week. Set aside that time for you to create, for you to explore. And even if you're an improviser creator type like me, and you need to be able to do what you want to do when you want to do it, when the passion strikes you, great. That's great. But have set times every day or a certain number of days per week where you commit to showing up for yourself in creativity, in that time that you have set aside, you can dance for an hour, or how many ever hours you have, say 2 hours. You can dance for 2 hours. You can free write. You can journal. You can film videos. You can color. You can pray, whatever it is. But that time is dedicated to your action that's directly connected to your decision, that's directly connected to what you're committed to in this life. This formula, while each one of these steps contains so much and there's plenty of room for getting confused or lost in your emotional states that come up because of resistance, if you can return to this simplicity, return to this simple recipe, it will not fail you. This simple recipe has saved me from my own mass mind confusion that usually is coming because of fear so many times. Break it down. Let it be simple. What are you committed to? You already know. Decide what you're going to do about that. Take action. From my heart to yours. I'll see you in the next video. Create, 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 my love. Create.